Alright folks, how you doing today? This is about night 3 of our run through with a new player. As you can see here, if you delete kitty. This kitty is going to be deleted shortly after I get through some of this series here. But hopefully we'll be able to see some of the good stuff here that we're doing. Currently, I have a crypto restoration staff. Because I do want to get into Cyrodiil and I do want to unlock this. It's going to be a little bit rough going with the damage on this. But hopefully I'm going to have enough to keep up and do some nasty things to the enemies, despite the fact I don't have the same amount of damage I used to. Just taking a look through here, see if there's anything else I can put on here to help me through this. There's not really not. The other thing I'm going to show here is that the fact that even though I have a bow skill here with a restoration staff, I'm still going to actually be training up my bow skill when I do this. So I'm just going to head in here and start doing some of this good stuff. We are again streaming on Twitch as well, so you'll be able to come in and get all this information on live if you have questions or anything else like that if you come into the channel. And people that are already currently in the stream, how are you doing tonight? Also, ESO has gone, during this series here, ESO has finally gone buy to play. And with the latest patch, I've been seeing a lot more stability. A few people might be noticed that we've been having a few issues here lately.
Yay!
Yeah, it does, doesn't it? Now, a few things to note with restoration staff and the logic of magic abilities. You do not get things like critical hits from stealth, like you would with a bow or other melee abilities. I'm enduring it for your people too, so.
The ancestors have forsaken.
The other good thing with the restoration staff is they have passes in it as well. They're gonna heal up your team if you want to. One of the good things about this, though, is using a Magicka-based abilities, I have a lot more stamina free to like block, bash, and dodge roll and all that good stuff. Dead, they just don't even know it yet.
Do you need a rest?
Yes, I do. Arrested development. See what I did there? Oh, ho, 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 so funny.
I'm glad you're down here, my friend.
I'm not really glad, but I'm here.
Beyond this door lies the ancestral chamber at the very heart of Tamzelda. If I complete the ritual and receive the ancestor's blessing, the people will finally accept me as King Tamriel's heir.
Alright. Now, this is a little bit harder to fight. I might have to switch abilities, but... since I've been putting some stuff in here. Have I gotten the first? Yep, Grand Healing. I love this stuff here. This is but primarily what we're going to be using inside PvP as well as Rapid Regen. See if we can delete some of the stuff here. Like this stuff I don't really need.
The ancestors honor your prayers. May the light of the eight bless you. Da, da, da.
Let your reign be long and peaceful.
Let's put those on. Yep, let's get the hell out of here. Come on, let's go.
All right, man.
See, we get a new bow for that too. And a skill point. Fortunately, we cannot complete it until we get ourselves a little bit of space free. Yeah, I'll get rid of that.
You risk. Go carefully on the roads, my friend. Of course, my friend. Our little adventure.
And now, the good thing here is I want to switch back over to bow. Since I got healing springs on this now, I can switch over to bow. Keep healing springs on there. Switch that out there. Oh, and I also have regeneration there. That's a pretty good one, too.
Yay.
So I'll level up these two abilities while still using my bow skills here with Venom Arrow. This guy's got to send me to another place here, and I can hopefully go sell off to someplace. This up here is a public dungeon. I'll probably hit that next. Probably going to be a lot of people there. Public dungeons are slightly harder than the standard delve, but you can usually get in there and do a bit of damage with it. And usually you find a couple people around there doing the same thing. Since it's the first day that ESO has gone live with the buy to play, there's probably going to be a couple people here in the new zone trying to grind themselves up really quick. So we should hopefully find some people to help us out with a bit of this stuff here. As you notice, with any time we go into some of these new areas here, you can hit F1, get more information about it. Your lore library has an entire list of some of the stuff there that's interesting to do. Okay, here we go.
Easy. Just put the sword down.
Discovered.
Good.
Yep, sure. We'll go deal with this place for you. Don't worry. Now, also, thing to remember as well is the, goddamn, I freaking forgot about those. Each dungeon and delve have at least a sky shard, and a public dungeon as well. They also have a challenge that will give you a skill point somewhere, like, locked inside that's hidden. We'll probably see one here as we come up here.
No hidden favors.
Yep, sure. Yep. You good goblin, I understand, don't worry. Now, these monsters are going to be a little bit harder than the standard monsters, but shouldn't be too bad for us here. Especially being bow users, we should be able to keep ourselves back unless we have to. If I remember, the first one here is possibly right back here. Nope. Oh yeah, here it is. This is like the first group challenge for the dungeon. These are slightly harder, and hopefully I don't get myself killed. Gotta kill all these spriggan here before I can actually complete it. Here. Again, these are challenging modes, but being a bow user at a low level, you usually take these out pretty easily. But luckily, I managed to kill that guy before he got me. Shoot, I am running seriously low on stuff here. I need to hit a bank here pretty soon. Yeah, get rid of that. These will sell for a lot more here. Actually, you know what? I can take that. That's already fire damage. Let's see. I should have some equipment here that's not quite... Yeah, you kind of can chant. Nope, I don't have anything here. Damn. Part of the problem is that some of the stuff here is... zero. Inferior. 5 and 15. 1 and 10. 1 and 10. 1 and 10. Some of the stuff here, the shocking damage ones here will be going over onto weapons. This goes against jewelry, which I think we have, yeah, one, but it's already being used. And this also goes against that, and that goes on clothing, so. So we got one of those monsters down, we got a skill point for that. Come on, superb parkour skills, come on. No? God damn it. As you can see here, we got a couple bosses up here. As well as our sky shard that's sitting way, way back in here. Okay, you got another skill point for that too. Damn. Bit too much for me. I can use a sky. I can use a a soul gem to get myself back up here, but getting these things out with taking on two boss mobs when you don't have a healer or anything like that is kind of rough. Let's see what I can possibly do here. Maybe put on more magicka. Oh shit. Yeah, they're immune to that. I'm in trouble here. Time to get away. Cutting does work. If you don't get yourself stuck. Ah, shit. Yeah, not good. Yeah, frickin' A. Yeah, I'm not gonna be able to take these guys on, unfortunately. Maybe with another level or two. But I do not have any sustainability attributes right now, so. Oh, shit. Again, this is made to be a much harder challenge in here as well. CC doesn't work the same way. As you can see, I got myself in trouble all the damn time. Friggin' A. Anyway, yeah, there's a bit more people in here today. Now I showed you what happens when you suck at trying to do some of the questing or some of the fights in here. Puppy dungeons are a lot harder, again, than most of the other delves in here. Being level 9, yeah, she can handle some of it, but I gotta get in there and see if I can find the evidence on this one here. There's somebody else here I can run with. Two of us can probably take out some of the stuff here. Again, it's a public dungeon. It's not made to be a simple pushover for a single player. I think I've also skipped over a quest here. Thought there was supposed to be one with Khajiit in here somewhere, but I don't see him anywhere. Actually, I might have to start that outside of this here. It doesn't matter. Somebody else trying to... Alright, they're trying to get in the same area we are. What you use for your skills, my recommendation, what I'm at least doing on this character right now, is I'm building a Venom Arrow, which is a interrupt one, which is a great one. Snipe is the other one that's definitely a want to have. Some of the other ones there depends on what you're going to do. If you're going to do PvP or a... if you're going to do PvP or PvE, it kind of depends on what you want to do with some of that. Alright, so come up here. Oh. Here's you. Alright. see, check all your bookcases. Cabinets. Two small ability contract, yep. And then we can leave and go find some more stuff on that. I'm currently playing on the Eldari Dominion. Right, I'm not sure what you mean by why are the people in the game red your enemies. Basically, if they have red when you hover over them, like these guys here, that means that they're hostile targets. They're going to attack you on sight. If they have yellow over them, that means they're not going to attack you on sight, or that they can be looted like that. And if they're white, that means you can pickpocket from them. Oh yeah, Togur the Skeever. Several places here. Sure. And as you can see, somebody just invited me to a group, and we'll go through on some of the stuff with them. Now, it's going to be a little interesting to some of the quests here. My guess is that, depending on what quest you're going on, assuming they have the same one as I do, probably do because they're doing this, they're going to get credit for it when I go in and loot something, or I'll get credit when they do it as well. So let's just watch them do it. As you can see there. So they made it a little bit more intuitive for the grouping mechanism. So if one person in the group gets it, the rest are going to get it as well. That's because they made it. They don't have names over the head, as you can notice that when I hover over them, up in the upper area here, up in this area right under the compass, you'll see the name. But they don't put names over it because it's a little bit more immersive in that fashion. It's a little bit more like Skyrim-esque. You can't really see somebody's name hovering over their head because, I mean, seriously, why are you seeing that right over their head? It doesn't make much sense. You can see we got a lot of other new players in here, but not too many. Now I'll take this here. They don't really need to do that themselves. They would have got credit for it as well. Yep, they're going this way. Room for this stuff here. No, I'm gonna just leave that. That's not too important to me right now. You should still use a passive skill tree. I mean, they're still very helpful in a lot of the ways that they do it. Yeah, I mean, I definitely recommend the passives there, but the skills are really where you have to, like, worry about the build there. Like, get all passives if you can, because passives are just going to help you overall. see what I got here now. Get one of that on there. On there. Okay. That way I can get rid of some of these here. See here, we got a few other people running through. And we got ourselves about halfway up into 9 now. We'll probably get ourselves up to 10 by the end of this here. How are you doing, Shoddy Magician?
If you so much as squawk.
Alright, so you got another choice in here to either fight this guy or side with him. Yep. Oh, he didn't even get a choice to kill him or not. Used to be you got like two choices, either kill him or confront him, and they must have taken that out there a little bit later. Probably saw that the choice didn't really matter that much. Oh yeah, each race gets like a different passive to it that they get in the racials here. Like Khajiit here, for example. Medium armor expertise. Experience gained in medium armor is up by 15% with those. So wearing medium armor, I level up fast. I level that skill up faster than any of the other skills. The other guys will get their bow skills up faster, but once you hit 50, it doesn't matter too much.
Wait, hear me out. Courteous of you. My terms are simple.
Yeah.
Don't worry. You won't see me again if I can help it.
Sure. Home sick alien, damage to the fall, man. Don't worry, Riot. That's one of the reasons a lot of the streamers do it. We love the game and we like teaching people how to play it if they're having issues or something like that, or just have general questions. And trust me, I learn a lot from my viewers as well. Mostly because if I do something wrong, people are going to tell me that I'm doing it wrong and then correct me like 5 or 6 times. But I understand, most people want to be helpful and okay, come up here. Okay, now you can see a trophy here. I hope you know what you're doing. Shoot's full. Yeah, it's level 3, I'll just get rid of that. And you notice that bear trap will come up there. And now I can get a little thing here that I can just kind of set down here. Now, it doesn't actually snare anyone, but it's a nice little visual effect that they add in. They get a trophy for every single public dungeon you go into. I've seen Arcade. I have not played it. But well, actually, I should say I played it back when it was on the Korean side of things. It was still foreign. Back then, it looked okay and it was kind of nice. But at the same time, when I saw the American port, I kind of started getting issues with it just because of the. You know, I was like, well, wait, what did they improve? What did they do? Okay, they're offering like a $200 Founders Pack. Okay, what are they going to do with this money? And then you start seeing the same MO for Tryon that you see with a lot of games there. So I did not get into Archeage when they put it out there. And as you can see, when you get into parties here, you can leave. Yeah, they already left before I even got up. And let's get over here, see if we can get to a merchant when we meet Razendar. Why? Oh yeah, I'm going to be playing ASO for a long time on this. I've got about 6 characters I need to level up there, and they have a lot more content coming up here that I am definitely going to be looking to play. And they got another quest here as well. One of the good things is, as you move through this area, all these quests here kind of lead one to another. You are encouraged to like go and explore, but it's like most of the stuff here that like people want to say that you know, they had a grind. I don't really understand it, because most of the stuff, if you're just like going and exploring and doing quests and looking around and like doing delves and all that stuff, there's no need to quest, or sorry, there's no need to grind. Now, there might be a need to do questing and all that stuff, because like some of the main story quests are pretty helpful on getting like skill points and all that stuff. And I won't disagree with that, but that's like the typical advancement on most of the stuff here. Yeah, die with your friend. There, you hugged each other. That's nice. Meow meow. Meow meow meow. Potency runes here. Heavy armor is increased. Shoddy, that sucks. Yeah, if your PC has issues with it, I will be going over a little bit later on some things you can do to improve performance a little bit, and different things with that. So we're gonna be able to do each one of these here. Now remember, folks, when I said earlier, like the first thing that you want to do is get your Fighter's Guild and be ready to use some of those abilities. Well, this is one of the reasons. Like everything that you do inside of these, inside of a lot of these quests here, involve Daedra or Atronachs or something else or undead. So the skill line is like really helpful for a lot of this stuff.
Get away from me. I'll kill you. I'll kill you.
Now again, if you want to take a look at the entire skill line here, or sorry, not the entire quest lines here, and understand what there are. I mean, a lot of these are good and in depth. I'm just kind of rushing through. How very uplifting.
matter of true love, those two.
Oh?
Marian finally finds love as a slave.
Why, if you're wondering about vampire, there's an entire skill line for werewolf and vampire inside here. It does require a bit of leveling though to get it. The quest is about level 40, but you can do it on low levels too.
They'll never turn for me, you know.
There we go. One last one, and we should be all set with this.
I'm all he can think about. Delicious.
Taking this jump here. Can be a little bit rough. I made it though. Thank you, Mushroom.
Don't ruin such an innocent.
Marian is mine. All mine.
What happened?
Oh. And now we leave. Yay.
True love denied. How interesting. How cruel.
You spent all your money on a horse. Well, remember, you can upgrade both your pack and your horse. They're both good investments, okay? If you're going to spend some crowns on the horse as well for a mount, that's another good one. Just remember, your horse that you buy on any character is shared across all accounts. So if you get a horse on one account, it's going to be on all accounts. And you can upgrade your riding skill with that to include capacity. If you want the maximum amount of your carrying capacity, you're going to have to upgrade both your pack and your horse. Okay, take that.
He suffers.
Now you might be wondering, how can I pick all this stuff up when I'm full on my stuff? The questing items here are luckily in a separate part of the bag here, which doesn't affect your overall count of items. As you can see here with the questing stuff. One item in here.
Slowly freezing to death. Painful, numbing.
Flint and tinder, and I gotta go start a fire now. Yeah, won't worry about that. Here we go to start a fire.
So warm. Never thought I'd feel warmth again.
Oh, no, wait, have a good night, man. And if you're looking for getting gold, I definitely recommend thieving. Good thief can make a good 10k in a night. Okay, confront him. Where am I confronting him? Oh, down here.
Thank you for your help, but sadly you are no longer useful. Prepare for death.
As you can see, that was pretty easy for us to get through. How to use maps. Maps aren't too hard to use. You can equip them into a quick slot or go into your inventory. They'll usually show up in your consumables. You just double click them, you'll get a little map for that. And that'll actually show into your main thing when you do it. Shoot, I gotta get myself some space here. I'm just gonna get rid of those. Sure. I believe you. Now let's get that level A down there. Girdle of stamina. I'm gonna put that on there. Okay, let's see if we can go get a merchant here somewhere where we can actually sell off some of our items. Now, as you notice, I was using bow there, getting restoration staff experience, because again, if you have restoration abilities slotted when you turn it in, you're going to get experience toward that. That's also a good way to get yourself up there. As you can see, you're getting real close. Oh, yep, I'm high enough for that. Restoration staff, one of the first things I recommend getting is this, and getting healing springs. So I'm going to get Magicka back for every time I use that. And we'll go into PvP later, you'll see why that's so very, very useful. Alright, I'm going to take this off as well. And do we have this up? Extended chains. Also be using extended chains a little bit in PvP, so I'm going to get that leveled up a little bit more. How are you doing, Mitosis? Alright, dude, let me go over some things with add-ons a little bit later here as well. That might help you out a little bit more if you got that many treasure maps. A reasonable ways to balance the power in PvP. Have an idea for earning personal points if you fight your side, number of disadvantages, kind of like planet side. Progress for once a month, switch alliances, people can naturally flock to ones that provide more points. That seems like an interesting idea, Axel. Definitely put that on the forums. One of the things I'm always, I always advocate is, like, any good ideas, put on the forums if you want to. You can always message me on there. It's Hero of None on there as well, but it's got, like, underscore ESO and some numbers after it. If you let me know that you're trying to, push an idea on the forums, I will absolutely take a look at it and see if I can give some help or at least argue with it so it's a little bit more, yes. So we just hit level 10 on this guy. I'm going to keep going a little bit here and sell off and get some of the other stuff done. Ah, hey though. Alright. Honoris.
Sure, I know about
so I don't think this took too long for us to get up to this level here. I spent a few days trying to get to this level. Just questing around, doing some minor stuff here and there. Got that done. And also, when you do hit level 10 here, you notice that Cyrodiil awaits and it tells you, hey, you can go into PvP now. Which is a helpful little thing there. How you doing, Java? Yeah, excellent. Definitely put it up on the forums there. Discuss a little bit more there, but again, certain things are good to argue in stream, and certain things are better to argue in on the forums as well, because you can put more thought to it inside of there and think a little bit more on top of it. All right, let's get on top there. I do a peeking. And again, people watching on on YouTube, I'm talking to people inside of Twitch as I'm streaming here. If you want to hear more of your name being said or something else like that, just make sure to stop in the channel anytime. Twitch.tv/Hero of None. Yeah, and just accept as well. Some people won't like your ideas, and some people will. Axel, if you take a look down my description there, it'll give a little bit more information on where my form is, my form handle is. You can also take a look at all the discussions I start. I put up a lot of suggestions there, so if you want to steal the formatting that I put up there, ultimately, you know, just go right ahead. I gotta talk to you. Yeah, your son's dead. Sorry. That was from a delve that we finished way, way back in the start of the area. We're going for this one here. Rustamdar's behind here. So I'll be completing this here, then giving a short highlight on a few other things there with what to keep and what to remove, as well as add-ons and a few other nice little things to have on top. Let's finish this up. The unveiling.
Let's tell Milani about that damn cat lurking around here. Aye, if Rasamdar is near, then trouble usually
follows.
ourselves.
Hey there, you're a bitch, aren't you? Yes, you are. You're doing some bad stuff.
Darling, take our friend here. Odin, dear, rally the troops. Time to drop the veil and show our troops.
And you just cold cock me in the back of the head. Hey there, remember me?
Now, sleeping kitten? What? Near his tail?
See, why my character just goes up and confronts him like that instead of, like, you know, being sneaky and possibly, like, assassinating? I don't exactly know, but... Peking, nope, I have not spent any crowns yet. Nope, where is this here? That side there. How am I stealing from this guy? This guy is freaking a piece of crap. I can't steal his crap.
Hail.
Hello. Yep, we're gonna go in there, we're gonna kick some ass, aren't we? Oh, down in here, smuggler's tunnel. Meow meow! How do you, Nate Dog? And some of these loading screens are a little bit long. Yeah, there we go. I've actually never been in here since they updated this part of the quest. Looks very interesting, though. Though, why does every smuggler's den have to be freaking in water? Understand that. Yeah, somebody else is coming through here right now. Standard MMO problems there. Waiting for a respawn, but not too long. Get my tincture of health there.
We are finished. Raz can't stand the stink of the forge anymore.
Okay, dude ninja, have a good night, man. That quest there, and now we can head up here and get to our major city. Our next major city, I should say.